This class we discuss about types of red lighting. There are four types. One is a faked lighting, number two sign lighting, number three flag lighting, number four general lighting. The first is a faked lighting. Faked is nothing but a front side of a building. Now we'll see the thumb rules of faked lighting. The first is a faked lighting. Faked means front view of the building. When lighting building faked, three factors to be considered. One is the setback distance. What is meant by setback distance? The distance between the building and the projector at the ground level is called setback distance. The recommended setback is 3/4 times, not 0.75 times the building height, or 3/4 times. If a building is 40 feet tall, here they consider a 40 feet tall, the recommended setback is 30 feet from the building, that is 40 into 0.75. The second term is spacing. What is meant by spacing? The distance between the two projectors, that is called spacing. The rule of thumb for setting floodlight is not to exceed 2 times the setback distance. In this case, the setback distance is 30. Therefore, the distance between the two projectors, 2 into 30 is equal to 60 feet. This is 60 feet. The third is aiming distance. What is this? The total height is 40. I have to aim for a distance. The floodlight should be aimed at least 2/3 the height of the building. If the building height is 40, 40 into 2 by 3 is equal to 26.67 feet. That is 27 feet. Next, I want to increase the aiming height. What I have to do? I have to raise the height of the projector from the ground level. By adjusting the height of the projector, I can vary the aiming distance. The second is sign lighting. Sign is nothing but an advertisement board. When lighting sign with the ground mounted floodlights, three factors to be considered. One is a setback distance, another is a spacing, another is a aiming distance. The thumb rule is 3/4 times the sign height. The height of the sign board is, or advertisement board is 8. The width is 16 feet. This is 8 feet, this is 16 feet. Therefore, 8 into 0.75, I will get 6 feet. Therefore, the distance between the advertisement board and the projector is 6 feet. The next is spacing. The thumb rule is 2 times setback distance. This is 6. 6 into 2, that is 12 feet. The distance between the two projectors is 12. Here the width is 16. Therefore, here this is 12. Next is aiming distance. Aiming distance is 2/3 times. 8 is the height, 2/3 times of the height of the sideboard or advertisement board. Therefore, 8, this is 8, 8 into 2 by 3, that is equal to 5.33. I want to adjust the aiming distance. According to that, I have to adjust the height of the projector. The third is a flag lighting. Ground mounted floodlights are used to provide illumination for flats. What are the factors to be considered? Number one, wattage of the lamp. Number two, distribution. How it is distribution. Number three, setback distance. Setback distance is nothing but the height of the pole. Suppose here this is the height is 40. The height of the pole is 40. 40 by 3 is equal to 13.33. Here this distance between the pole and the project is 13.33 feet. And the aiming. So aiming is very, very important. For we have to considering aiming point of view, we have to choose the right pictures, appropriate pictures are very, very essential. Then another is the spacing, how many lights are required to focus this flag. For that, we have to consider the pole height, flag size and ambient light level. But in the case of, we are using three projectors with the same pictures, what we are doing is, these projectors should be placed 120 degree apart. This is a flag lighting design. The fourth is general lighting. Factors to be considered are mounting height, spacing, vertical aiming, horizontal aiming. First, we have to find the mounting height. Thumb rule is mounting height is equal to 1 by 2 into distance to be lighted. Here, the distance to be lighted is 40. Therefore, 40 into 1 by 2 is equal to 20 feet. Okay. Next is spacing. Spacing thumb rule is pole placing is equal to 4 into mounting height. The mounting height is 20. 20 into 4 is equal to 80. The distance between two poles is 80. Here the distance between two poles is 80. Here we are using 4 projectors. So such a way that we have to space to be provided. Number 3, aiming distance. Aiming distance is, the thumb rule is 2 by 3 into 40, that is 27. Here this is 27. Here we have to give 30 degree. This distance between this lamp to and this point is 30 degree to avoid glare. Number 4 is horizontal aiming. Suppose we are using two lamps. Our aiming line should be like this. The angle between these two, it should be 90 degree. The last is monument lighting. For designing monument lighting, we have to consider three factors. One is most prominent feature, that is characteristics of monument such as face or emblem. Second point is we have to select a proper illumination level. Number three, whether we are going for a single light or three light, it all depends upon the value, and our aim is to enhance the value of the or the details of the statue. Either we can fix here or we can fix here, that all depends upon the face or emblem, what we are going to concentrate, that is the most important thing. Number 2, texture. Texture means essential quality of something. Develop a gracing effect by placing fixtures at the base of the statue. We can develop some gracing effect. For that we have to select a proper illumination level, select a proper fixture, and we have to fix the base of the statue. The third is profile and silhouette. Silhouette means a drawing of the outline of an object. Provide sufficient background illumination. This is the background. We have to provide a proper illumination of the background so that a strong ascent effect exists between the background and the statue. This is the monument lighting. There is no specific thumb rule for monument lighting. The objective is we have to enhance or improve the details of the monument or a statue. So it all depends upon the taste of the illumination engineer. Suppose you are an illumination engineer, you have to design in what way we have to attract the tourist or the people by using lighting. While considering the monument lighting, we have to consider the surrounding lighting also. That's the very most important point. Thank you.